the formulas regarding the bolted connections. Those are shear capacity of the bolts and also bearing capacity of the bolts. Anyway, I will share the PPT and I will write in here. My dear students, the page number 75, all the formulas are available regarding shear capacity of bolts, bearing capacity of bolts. So we have to solve the problems by using these two conditions only. So before that, I will explain each and every formulas. So when you want to calculate the tensile strength, that is the design tensile strength, the formula is Tdn equal to 0.9 An into Fu by gamma ml. So this gamma ml is the factor of safety. We will take as a 1.25. And Fu is the ultimate stress. And An is the net effective area. There is a separate formula for, again, net effective area, An equal to B minus N D naught plus summation of PSI square by 4GI multiply with P. So these all formulas are available in the page number 75, okay? So here B is the width, okay? And minus N is the number of bolts, D is the diameter, PS is the staggered pitch, and DA is the gauge length, okay? And sometimes if there is no staggered length, this one completely zero. So at that time, the net effective area, we have to calculate like this, ND naught into T, okay? This is the basic thing. And moving ahead to the design strength of bearing bolts under the shear, is the least of the following, that is the shear capacity and also bearing capacity. Now the shear capacity of a bearing bolts in joint, we have to discuss each one, okay? The first one, these are all available in the code book. I will open that also, please wait for 1 second. Yeah, so you see, in the page number 75, all of you open page number 75, directly they're given the design strength of bolt VDSB as governed as a shear strength. VDSB equal to VNSB by gamma MB. Anyway, I will write clearly for your better understanding. Okay, so each step I will write clearly, but please look into the page number 75 of IS 800-2007 code book. Okay, the first one, shear capacity. Strength, shear capacity of bearing bolt in a joint. The formula for this, say in the bolted connections, we have only calculation is shear capacity and bearing capacity. Okay. In this, the design strength of bolts, the first formula, VDSB equal to VNSB by gamma MB. This is the formula where we use to design strength of a bolt. Okay. VNSB. What is this one? VNSB. VNSB is a nominal shear capacity of a bolt. Nominal shear capacity of bolts. Gamma MB is nothing but partial safety factor of the bolts. So my dear students, this one already it is available in the code book also. Please look into that in the page number 75. You see VSB equal to VNSB by gamma MB. It is clearly shown in the code book. Okay. Coming to the next one. Yes. So here, how we will calculate this VNSB? How we will calculate? Okay, VNSB is the normal shear capacity of the bolt, whatever we discussed in the morning. Okay, VNSB formula I will write here. VNSB equal to FUV by root 3 into NN into ANB plus NS into ASB. This is the formula where we have to use for the normal shear capacity of the bolt. So here FUB is nothing but ultimate tensile strength of the bolts. Okay. And if you observe ANB, it is the net area, net shear area. I will tell you one important thing. If it is a bolt and this one is the head, okay. So sometimes we have to calculate as a, this one we call it as a thread. The area you have to calculate based on the thread and also, 1 minute, okay. So here we have to calculate nominal shank area of the bolt. ASB is the only shank area. That means when there is a shank, this one. Okay, next. Net shear area, if you observe the net shear area of the bolt, that is ANB, and this one is the shank area. And now coming to the NN, what is NN and also NS? That means the number of shear planes, number of shear planes with threads, and same thing NS, number of shear planes without threads. So this is the formula where we have to calculate. Anyway, you will understand clearly once you start the problem. So this problem, this theory also, this one also shown in the IS 800. I will show you that one. You see, this formula is there. No need of by-hatting any equation here. You can directly take from this IS 800. All the things are there. And anyway, I will tell you one important thing here. Okay. So from, I will take one equation, sorry, one diagram like this. Okay. Yes, my dear students, there is a small interruption. Okay. I will share the screen. Please wait for 1 second. Yeah. So how we will take NN and NS value? So here it is a thread, NN and also NS. NN is 1, NS equal to 0. If you take here the thread value, the number of shear planes here, it is like this. You see, the load is applying here and load is applying here. That means loads are separately. If it is take like this. So here there is a one shear plane will happen due to the thread. There will be a thread. Okay. And without threads, the shear planes are zero. Okay. Definitely when the thread is there, definitely the pull will be like this. But if you take one more important thing, if the diagram is like this, when there are two types of like this, NN equal to 2. Why? Because two shear planes are there. So NN equal to 1, the shear plane for the two bolts, and without the threads also, there will be a one plane is there here. Why? Because here, it is like this, only load is acting in one plane. Anyway, I will explain this one once we will start the theory. Definitely, I will explain exactly how we will take that one. Don't worry regarding that. So next, how we will calculate the ANB? ANB is the net shear area of the bolts of threads. Okay. The formula for this, pi by 4 into D minus 0.9382 into P square. Okay. P whole square. So P we know already, that is the pitch. Okay, otherwise, there is one more formula, 0.78 pi by 4 into D square for ISO standards. So our ISO threads. Okay. Next, Coming to the IS 800, I will show you the same formulas are available here also. You see, whatever we discussed till now, these two formulas are written here. And one important thing, if their joints are, the code suggests the use of reduction factors for the shear capacity. If the joint is too long or if the grip length is large, whatever it may be, if the packing plates of thickness more than 6 mm are used. That means when the joint is very more, for suppose. So at that time, which type of the formulas we use? Okay, I will write the reduction factors. This one, there is a formula for the, if the joint is very large, definitely we use this formula. And the grip length is large, definitely we use another formula. The for packing plates, we use one more formula. Okay, like that we have three formulas are there here only. From the 10.3.3.1 is a long for long joints, and 10.3.3.2 for large grip lengths, and 10.3.3.3 for packing plates. These are the three conditions are available, especially when we take the reduction factor for shear capacity of the bolts. Anyway, I will write here for your understanding. My dear students, no need of by-hatting anything. All the formulas are available here in the IS 800 code book. I will write here within 1 minute. Okay, please wait for 1 second. Yeah, reduction factor. The first one, the reduction factor for long joints, beta ij. The formula is beta ij equal to 1.075 minus 0.005 lj minus d. So here the lj is the last bolt in the joint. Whatever in the joint we will take, lj is the last one. If the distance between the first and the last bolt in the joint measure in the direction of load exceeds 15 d, okay, the shear capacity VdB shall be reduced by this reduction factor. That means, my dear students, there is a condition, the distance between the first and also last bolt. Suppose you have different types of the bolts are there, okay, in a plane. If you take, okay, the difference between first to last bolts, okay, in the joint measured in the direction of loads, so in the direction of the load, it will exceed the 15 times the diameter. What happens? We have to decrease the nominal shear capacity or normal shear capacity VdB. Okay, that is the formula Bij equal to 1.075 minus 0.005 Lj by D. This is the reduction factor. We have to decrease the shear capacity when the difference between the first bolt to last bolt, okay, if it is exceed in the direction of the load, exceeds the 15 times the diameter of the bolt, definitely we have to reduce the shear capacity. This is the one reduction factor for the long joints. The second one, reduction factor, if grip length is large, the formula is beta LG equal to 8D by 3D plus LG. These formulas are available in the code book directly. What the code is saying, the total thickness of the plates, whatever it may be, if it exceeds the 5 times of the diameter of the bolt, the design shear capacity VdB, we have to reduce by this reduction factor, 8D by 3D plus LG. Okay. And next one, coming to the LG is nothing but grip length. The all are available in the code book, please refer. Okay. And also, for suppose the reduction, the third one, the reduction factor, if packing plates are used, that is beta PK. Formula for beta PK equal to 1 minus 0.0125 PPK. This is one condition when we have to reduce the reduction factor. The packing plates, whatever we are taking the plates, you see this type of plates. So in this we have bowls, okay? But what is they are saying? The plates, whatever we are taking, these plates, the thickness is more than 6 mm used in the joint. The shear capacity we must be reduced by using this formula. Okay, here TPK is nothing but thickness of thicker packing. It is in mm. Okay, my dear students, these are the reduction factor we have to use in different molds design. Next, till now we discussed about the shear capacity, but what about the bearing capacity of the bolts? The bearing capacity of the bolts, that is VDBP. The shear capacity means VDSB. Okay. So here the formula for the IS from the IS 800-2000 code book. What it is saying for the bearing capacity of the bolt, VDBP, VNBP, NPB by gamma MB. So here VDBP means design bearing strength here, VNBP means nominal bearing strength. This is partial safety factor. Anyway, I will show you this one from the code book. Please look into this one. So all are available in the code book. Yes, my dear students, see the lap joints formula is there, grip formula is there, bearing capacity formula. Now whatever we are discussing, that formula, it is available here. The design bearing strength of bolt on any plate VDPB is equal to VNPB by gamma MB. That's why, my dear students, it's my sincere request, all of you, please take a printout of IS 800 code book. Please follow, the page number is 75. Okay, now, what about from that, what we have to learn? Yeah, so now here, please 1 second. So the formula is VDPB equal to VNPB by gamma MB. Now, what about VNPB, the formula? It is a nominal shear strength equal to 2.5 times KB into VTFU. This is the formula for the normal shear strength. This is also available in the code book, where B equal to what is called diameter of the hole, and FUB and FU, these are the ultimate tensile strengths of the bolt. Small d, this is a d naught. Small d, when you need small d, that is a nominal dia of the bolt. But here there is a KB, there is a factor. KB is nothing but, where KB is smaller of E by 3 D naught or P by 3 D naught minus 0.25 or FUB by FU or 1. Here E and P are edge distance, comma pitch distance. Okay, FUB and FU are ultimate tensile strengths. Okay, D naught, I told you, diameter of the hole, and D equal to nominal diameter of the bolts. Yeah. So still now, whatever we discussed, this one for the bearing capacity and this one for the first one is the shear capacity we discussed, and also some reduction factors we discussed. This is the shear capacity, Okay, nominal shear capacity of the bolts, the formula, and also bearing capacity. This is the formula, normal bearing capacity. So normal shear capacity, normal bearing stress, whatever it may be, bearing strength, we discussed. These are all very small problems. Okay, but all the problems equations are available. See, whatever I wrote, it is 2.5 into Kb into D into T into Fu. This one also it is there. And here it is there, all the nomenclature. So when the other conditions also is there, whenever you are free, please look into this one. And even tension capacity also is there, TB less than TDB. As well as if the bolt is subjected to the combined shear and also tension, what happens? The formula for the combined tension and the combined shear, it is like this. VSB by VDB square plus TB by TDB square. Anyway, actually no need this one. We have only shear and bolted capacity. So this formula also we use. All the formulas are available here only. Please look into this one. You will get a clear idea. So all the things, whatever we have to design, this one is for the welded and welding. Once if you enter into, after the bolted connection problems, we will enter into the welding connection at that time. I will explain all these things, okay?